So what, with the help of automation, what you can do now the scenario is clear to you. You know how automation can help in fetching the data from your database. Okay, right now we are focusing on automation. Okay, Selenium is there, but right now our focus is on automation, and whatever scenario I'm taking, you can do with Selenium also. Now you don't have to do it, just prepare your test script once. Now these guys are happy, we have already prepared the script, we'll just put it on the execution, whether it is a financial, e-commerce, telecom, whichever vertical it is, not a problem. It will go and execute it. And once the execution gets completed, screenshots, test result files, graphical analysis reports will be auto-generated. Okay, and this is the auto-generation of everything. Okay, and taking screenshots and auto-generation of reports. So this is what the data has come out from the execution, and with that data, a data has been generated for the higher management to do some analysis. Okay, so that's what the flow is. So what effort you have put, you have just click on run and everything is done by itself, and you will get the output. So here you are saving lots of time also. Okay, we'll come to know how automation is helpful in other things as also. Okay, but as of now, for this scenario, this flow is like that. Okay, this flow is clear to you guys. So now this guy is happy. He is thinking, okay, thank God you automation has saved me. Now I won't be crying it that I have to do the same process again and again. So that's actually true. Now I don't have to do the same process again and again, right? Because we were testing the same thing, same process again and again. And don't have a confusion in the mind that automation is for that application which is always fixed. No, automation is for dynamic applications as well. Okay, so dynamic has many meanings. We in further slides will come to know. In between, if you have, anyways, I'll be taking up that example, but in between, if you have any scenario, just ask me that you had this scenario and how can we automate that thing. Okay, because dynamic means data can be dynamic, it can be your web, it can be the flow, how to do it. It can be a change in your application. I wanted to write once and do 10 things. That can be an example of dynamic also. Okay, so we'll be taking up that examples. So where exactly we are? So finding defects missed by manual testing. So I'll quickly, that was a very good feedback, because see, if you come up with those types of things, that will also help me, because my aim is to make you understand the scenarios. Okay, if you guys are okay, I can slowly move forward fast. Okay, and let me know if I'm too going into explanation. So test usage is what, like, you need a quick feedback, you don't want to miss manual scenarios, you need everything to be done on time, you have very limited scenarios to test it, but with automation when you go, you can do it. And when it comes for agile, extreme development methodologies and agile development, like there is a case that your development team is doing some development and at the same time you have to test the application. Okay, so if your test scripts are up and running, you don't have to retest everything, because once your test scripts are ready, you can put it on execution and it will execute it. Okay, and there will be a disciplined documentation of the test case. You will be knowing the process, how exactly it is and how it can be done. And then defect reporting will be easy with automation, because you have to go to a log tracker where, or a defect log, you have to log it, and then but when you do it, things gets auto-generated. Okay. So how it will be? Cost reduction, reusability, you can reuse your test cases, it will be fast. Unattended execution, you can execute on a do execution on a dedicated machine. Okay, thanks Shovan. You can do your execution on a dedicated machine, or you can minimize your browser and do the execution. It will be reliable. Why? Because I just now I took an example about the missed out in the calculation of the value. So it will be reliable, because whatever things you have written, that only will be tested. Okay, better quality, because whatever things you have done, it's not a random thing that you are going to do. This is what you have already done. You have written and you wanted it to be. Okay. So what is the disadvantage on automation? Okay, it's not easy. Okay, why it's not easy? Because you have to be skilled in scripting. Whatever process you have, it's not that anything you will write and will it will work for you. No, you have to write very specific things, very specific keywords to make it run, and it should be in a proper documented way. Okay. Automation script errors. If you write anything in anything wrong, any wrong step in your script, it will fail. Complexity. It depends how you are writing your test script. If you are trying to put everything in one test script, it will become a junk data for you. Next time when you yourself will see into it, it will be difficult for you to fix it. But if you categorize in your test script in modules, it will be easy for you to go ahead and do it. Okay. And debugging, because if you put everything in one place and wanted to say that, okay, I have 100 test cases, I wanted to put in one place and do it in one flow, that is wrong. You can do it in one flow, but have it in a separate in Excel sheet we'll be preparing. So have it a separate classes or separate tabs for that, so that if anything goes wrong, you can go to the specific script and do it. So overall disadvantage is what? It's you who is doing the who is misusing the automation. You are not documenting it properly. You are not writing the test case properly. Okay. So can everything be automated? So I've already answered this question. I've taken many scenarios. So it's like if on regular basis, if things are changing, so you should not go. And if you have a very short deadline, you should not go. Okay. Let the application come up. If it is changing in your regular basis means what? Like you have an application and it is very initial phase of building it. Like hardly 5% of things have built up in the application. Then there is no point in going with automation, because in coming 3 or 4 days, again, they'll change the application. Again, in 1 month, they'll change the application. So let the application get completed, build it completely, then go with automation. Okay. So what are the automation tools we have? QTP, Selenium, IBM RFT, SQLi is for image recognition, Silk Test, Test Complete. So there are many automation tools in the market, but the best known is what? The leading ones are which tools? HP QTP, Selenium, IBM RFT. So all three has their own pros and cons, but somewhere Selenium is leading them much ahead. It's much ahead them. Okay, in few of the things. Okay, so let's go to the next slide. So in now you can correlate the things, friends. Why QTP, IBM RFT, and Selenium? Okay. Why should you go for Selenium if QTP is there? Why should you go for IBM RFT if Selenium is there? Okay, I'll go through this slide quickly. Okay, ask me if you have any confusion, any doubt. Okay, I think the data which is written in the slide is very much clear. QTP, IBM RFT are licensed, but Selenium is open source. If you go with a knowledge, if you want to gain a knowledge in a QTP or IBM RFT, you need to pay more because it's a licensed tool. You have to pay for the license, because whosoever or the company is or the trainer is, they have to pay for the tool. Then only you can get the full access to it, and then you will come to know. But with Selenium, it's an open source. You can do it easily. When you go with QTP and IBM RFT, you have a dedicated team to resolve your issue. If today is anything is going wrong in your applic tool, then there is a dedicated team which will be helping you. But in QTP and IBM RFT, like in Selenium, you don't have any dedicated team. It's an open source, so it's a community that where you will be actually connected and you will get the things out of it. Okay, so there are many people who are working on this community, and you will get the your solution from the blocks. Okay, but for you guys, you have an additional benefit of getting the solution done from Edureka. So there is a very big group of people who are sitting here and helping the resources who actually wanted to get the things done and wanted to resolve their issues. Okay. Hardware requirement for QTP and IBM RFT is high. I'm not comparing QTP and IBM RFT. I'll compare these two with Selenium. So the requirement, hardware requirement is high, but for Selenium is very, very, very low. Okay. Very low means it's in less than 100 MB, I should say. But for QTP and IBM RFT, it will, you need a very good, for at least for installation, you need 4 GB. Then you need some extra, when it will be running, it will occupy your RAM space. So when RFT runs, I was doing, I was working on IBM RFP. I've worked on IBM RFP also for mainframe and web automation also. I've done automation of web with IBM RFP. So that time, if you can go to the configuration, you can see it will occupy 1 GB of your space. Okay. So if you do a bulk testing, your RAM will go down and it will hit your RAM and your execution will stop and it will generate a dump files in your project. Okay. For QTP and IBM RFT, coding experience is required in some specific languages. But for in Selenium, you don't have to be very much specific to a language. Like for QTP, you should know VBScript only. For IBM RFT, you should know Java and C#, JavaScript only, okay, C#. But in Selenium, you can come from any platform and do the things, okay. QTP, the very drawback, what I feel about QTP is that it runs on Windows only. But IBM RFT also runs on Windows and Linux, Mac also, not only Windows, okay. It provides support for that. And the Selenium can runs on any platform, Windows, Linux, Solaris, Mac, any platform. It supports all the platforms. Languages, it's very much restricted. You should know only VB. For IBM RFP, you should know Java and C# and JavaScript, but with Selenium, you can come from any background, okay? So I think this picture gives you a very clear concept why Selenium, friends, right? Okay, Sambha has a question. If there is an issue, if I'm pronouncing it wrong, Ravi, can I call you Shiva? Shiva is okay? Yes, okay. Because I was a little bit confused, okay. So if Shiva has a question, if there is an issue found in Selenium, okay, support fix may be late because it's an open source. Did you hit or know any issue in Selenium? Did you hit or know any issue in Selenium? Okay. See, Shiva, are you thinking that Selenium is a tool? Can you answer me this, yes or no? No, okay, you are not thinking Selenium is a tool. Then what does that mean? I didn't get it. You wanted to ask that when you are doing something in between, you are facing some issue in your coding, or you are asking that when you are doing something, you found some issue in Selenium and you wanted to get it fixed. What it is exactly? Because it's an open source. Okay, so I think you wanted to ask that if you face any problem in Selenium, how to do it, right? Yes. So thing is that let's be very clear. See, it's an open source. There are, I'll tell you a few blocks where you can go. Actually, we'll be covering most of the scenarios, but then also let me take you to I had somewhere a blog community. Yes, this is a very good community, Google community. Okay, I'll share the link with you guys. So here you can actually go and see people are putting up their questions. Okay, you can join the community, you can put up your questions. Okay, this is a case when you are not getting an answer for your question. When something you have found and it is just like anything new, you have want to invent it and put it there. But 99.99% you will get your answers from Stack Overflow. Okay, I'll show you a site. Because as per my experience, friends, like if I initially, for me also it was new, okay, I was like you only, okay, and within a year of like I was able to visualize each and every scenario. I had worked on so many concepts that I was just once or twice I have worked, then I'll know, okay, this is the place where I got it, this is how it has to be done. Okay, there are few things only that you need to understand. Remaining things you can, you, like in Selenium, you can have a few like grab 10% of knowledge of like full scenarios. Like in 10% of your knowledge of Selenium can help you in exploring many things. Okay, so I'll just give you an example. Selenium in Selenium plus Stack Overflow. So this is a site where you can get all your questions. It means you can get answer for all your questions. I'll put it in a chat window. Okay. So these blocks and these sites will help you in answering it, and above on that, we guys will help you in resolving the issues. And the best part is that whatever test cases and scenarios we have, okay, I have tried my best to put all in my PPT, okay, it's the and the LMS that you can see there. I'll be uploading each and every how to interact with checkbox, how to upload a file, how to take a screenshot, how to select a value from a drop down, how to enter the value in a text box, how to handle security enabled web browsers. You can see, you will get a link continue to the website. So whatever scenario is there, we will be discussing. Okay, I am very sure from my end that I have not missed a single point, but if any 1% of chance is there and you are coming across such scenario, drop me a mail directly. That time itself I'll help you, okay, or the support team. Do you mean Selenium is not a tool? Yes, Ranjit has a question. Do you? Okay, thanks Shiva. I think I have answered your question, Shiva, right? Any Shiva, I have answered. Yes, okay. Just let me know. Even if I am answering, doesn't mean you have to say yes. You can crossfire me. No, Sushobit, this is not the thing I was expecting. Can you come up again? You have full rights to ask. Ranjit asks, do you mean Selenium is not a tool? Yes, Ranjit. I was about to come to that point. Okay. So Selenium is not actually a tool. It's a Java API, which you will be using it to design a framework. That is a very good thing. You don't need any installation. You don't have to download it. With a very less system requirement, you can do the things. Okay, Ranjit is saying, but that Stack Overflow website you opened says Selenium is an open source tool. No, Ranjit, people will say like Selenium is a tool, but actually Selenium is not a tool. Selenium is a Java API, Selenium WebDriver. Yes, when Selenium came up, it came with a tool called Selenium IDE. We'll come up. We are about to reach there. Okay. So we'll come up what tool we have in Selenium. Okay.